Welcome, sports fans. As the champions battle it out in the Tour de France, we invite you to get on your own bike for a rather special ride. As you make a supreme effort to keep the pedals turning, do you ever wonder about the energy you're expending or the power you are developing? Or maybe, as you approach the summit of a big mountain pass in the searing midday heat, your mind turns to more existential questions, like, what am I doing here? Where do we even come from, and where are we going? If so, you're in luck. It's questions like these that the Large Hadron Collider, LHC, tries to answer. What's the LHC, I hear you say? In a 27-kilometer tunnel straddling the Franco-Swiss border, it might look like the world's biggest velodrome, but it's actually the largest scientific instrument on the planet. In the outskirts of Geneva, 100 meters underground, a kind of giant 27-kilometer-long velodrome containing two beams of particles circulating in opposing directions at close to the speed of light, each comprised of nearly 3,000 proton bunches. There are approximately 100,000 million protons in a bunch. A proton is a positively charged subatomic particle. And yes, they are allowed to be positive. Thousands of magnets direct the beams along their subatomic velodrome. 1,232 dipoles and 392 quadrupoles. How are they accelerated? To move your bike forward, you push one pedal while you pull the other. In the LHC, there are radio frequency cavities that store an electromagnetic field to attract and repel protons. All the RF cavities in the LHC are regulated to oscillate at a frequency of 400 MHz, or 400 million cycles per second, while the frequency of your pedaling is about 1.5 cycles per second. A proton bunch, on the other hand, circles the LHC 11,245 times per second. Physicist and cycle lover Albert Einstein predicted in his formula E equals mc squared that matter transforms into energy and vice versa. Nothing travels faster than light. However, when proton bunches in the LHC get near to light speed, they become heavier. For cyclists, though, the more you cycle, the more weight you are likely to lose. A proton bunch has an energy of about 110 kilojoules. A bunch of Tour de France cyclists has an energy of about 530 kilojoules. Remember, though, that there are thousands more proton bunches in the LHC than competing cyclists. For a cyclist, as you ramp up from 0 to 36 kilometers an hour in 10 seconds, you need 500 watts of power. A bunch of protons ramping up the LHC for 20 minutes needs only 85 watts of power. There are many more particles in a cyclist than in a bunch of protons. Our protons will collide at four points around the LHC, in the detectors called ATLAS, ALICE, CMS, and LHCB. These particles are so tiny that this equates to throwing two needles at each other from 10 kilometers away. Like the collision between two cyclists would cause pieces to detach, wheels, frames, tires, helmets. The collision between protons produces a wealth of particles. The giant detectors behave like bicycle computers, recording important data. These data are sent to huge computing centers to be analyzed, similar to sporting performance applications. So next time you take a spin on your bike, think about those tiny subatomic particles in their underground velodrome whizzing around to help us understand what we, and our bikes, are made of.